Hello? Welcome to Community Corner with Big Jim. Tonight's a part three series. That's right, we're in part two, episode one, where the Litchfield Fire Department had some house burning exercises on search and rescue and containing fires and anything you want to know about a fire. It's in these three shows. The last show was more the exercises of rescue and search for firefighters in a building in case it was burning. Tonight is the beginning stage of actually setting the house on fire. Some more exercises, a lot of education. Stick around. I hope you enjoy the show. And Community Corner, Big Jim, it's all about the community.
I boarded up the window when we were here last time, but it's nasty weather. That might help, or I don't know if it hinders. What do I know? I'm not a fireman, but anyways, I'm all ready to go over here, and we'll just kind of like zoom in and check out some of the firefighters, see what they're talking about. And this burn is maybe down.
Thank you.
Fire burn in the corner.
See the fire going?
I can. Can smell it.
Eventually, once that gets going, I have to get down a little.
So what are they actually doing right now?
What we're doing right now is we're doing basic fire behavior. And we'll apply it very, very, very first start until it actually starts rolling over the ceiling.
Okay.
So what's going to happen? You'll
see the flames now.
You'll see the flames, right? There's an instructor there, and they're talking about how a fire works, how it gets started,
how it starts,
the heat starts building, all the smoke will start banking down. You'll see once they close that door in the kitchen. You should start seeing smoke banking down from the ceiling. From the ceiling down. See it?
See the smoke up? Yeah, it's coming starting on top, coming down.
Yep. So all the hot gases, the smoke, the heat are all going up into the ceiling. And they're starting to work their way down.
Which actually is even hiding the fire.
Exactly.
The flame.
Yep.
Now what are these guys doing right here that are on their knees? What are they waiting
on? They're listening to the instructor right now.
Okay.
There's an instructor in there and they're talking about how fire works. Eventually what'll happen is that fire, I don't know if you can see in your camera, but that'll turn to like a dull glow in that corner.
It's getting close to that now, huh? Can you see the flame?
Yeah, you got the flame on there.
Okay. And you can probably feel the heat coming out the door, right?
Yeah, I can definitely feel. Why don't you back up a little bit, Chris?
Is that it? Just go down, Chris. I mean, he's, you know, right down.
Okay.
There we go.
See the smoke coming out. Unless you have the heat.
Listen, no.
Well,
it'll pass. Yeah. So we don't want you to feel that. That's why you can just throw it back on and go in.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Are you able to see through the window, Chris?
Yeah. Yep.
Okay, and if you back up, you can start seeing the smoke come out.
Just take it in with us.
Come down to about this level.
Go ahead.
Now.
I'll give it to you.
What's that?
He said he'll take it in with him. He said, go ahead.
How much heat can the camera take? I'll just take it in.
Can I?
I follow.
We got the guys that are coming out here. This is the second group, the second fire that started. As you can see, the soot on their mask is unbelievable. I just touched a couple of their helmets and they are pretty hot. A couple of the guys are already drinking some fluids. I think they might have got some smoke in them. But I don't know about you folks, but I don't want to be standing next to that window, that door there with all that smoke coming out right now. But it's what they live for. This is what they live for. Check these guys out over here. Now we got a fan coming by the looks of it. But gonna add to the situation. Now, if it was really hot today, I think I'd be standing right underneath that little waterfall right over there.
Hey, Tim, what's the story with the, why is the water coming out of the
top? The water's coming out because it's a closed system, and if they're not using water, the pump generates heat, and heat builds up in the water, and the water begins to boil, and the boil creates pressure, and then it blows up.
Wow.
So we're bleeding off water to circulate it so that the water in the pump is cool.
Okay.
So it's essentially just circulating the water.
Wow. Okay, so the smoke's still coming out, folks. And guys are standing around, they're talking, their experience and all. So let's see if I can get my cameraman, Chris, to get a little closer to this next fire that starts up. And sooner or later, I'm going to put a mask and a tank on to show you what these guys have to go through. It's also going to be some fun for me. Community Corner with Big Jim, burning down the house. All right, I got Bill, Lieutenant of the Litchfield Fire Department here. Now, we're about to go in where they actually started off their what, maybe three, four fires?
Three, four fires. It was all fire behavior, so you can see from the incipient stage how the fire starts to build up, and then you see all the layering of the smoke and the heat as it works its way down, then as the smoke will, fire will roll up over the top of you. Just fire behavior.
Right. Now, a few of the guys said it was the first time they've ever seen a fire start like that, and it was very cool to watch.
Yep.
Seeing how it breathed and got bigger and all. So, very educational, just that aspect alone.
Right, and that's actually a stage that we never really get to see.
Right, well, let's go in and see basically where they set the fire at. And, by the way, I took the helmet off because I don't know how hot it's going to be. I didn't want to melt on my head, but we got the temperature turned up here with the hat on. All right, let's go inside here. I'm going to put my light on.
All right.
And wow, still pretty smoky in here.
Still smoky, it takes a while. That's where they started the fire. You can see how it started climbing up the walls and up onto the ceiling.
Now, was this wall all the same color,
blue? This was all the same color.
Same color. So wherever you see the paint gone is where the flame was.
Well, not only just the flame, but the high heat will melt
that
right off.
Yep. And it's still smoldering. So now you poured oil, it looks like on top of some hay. And a pallet?
Just as an ignition source.
Okay. And, this whole room filled up with smoke now. The whole house is going to go down, so are you going to reset a fire in here after a while, or just kind of let the fire take its course?
We may actually set some fires in here. It depends on how it's going to go for the rest of the day.
Okay.
So we definitely could set another fire in here if we wanted to.
So you could tell there was a lot of heat up in the ceiling.
Yeah.
And, I went through here before, and there really wasn't much peeling and stuff that I can remember up there.
Right.
So that's just from the cause of today.
Right.
And would you say that, how big of a fire was that, would you say?
It really didn't get, maybe got up to about this area here.
Okay.
But it was pretty much contained right to this area. But it heated up real quick, and you could have a very big difference in the heat from where it could be 800,000, 2,000 degrees up here, and it could be 300-400 degrees down here.
All right, we're going to come on out here now.
Thanks for watching tonight's show, and don't forget the next time the house goes down, or should I say up in flames, Community Corner with Big Jim. Thanks for watching. Big Jim, live it up and keep it real.